major economic developments stateside and in the region. The U.S. Federal Reserve finally keeping its rate steady after 10 consecutive hikes. Its latest decision keeps its benchmark rate between 5 to 5.25%. The widely anticipated pause comes on the back of a cooler inflation in the U.S. in May at 4%, the lowest in 2 years. But Fed Chair Jerome Powell signals there could still be more hikes ahead.
I think if you look at the core PCE inflation overall, look at it over the last 6 months, you're just not seeing a lot of progress. It's running, and it's running at a level of, you know, over 4.5%, far above our target, and not really, you know, moving down. We want to see it moving down decisively. That's all. We're, you know, of course, we are going to get inflation down to 2% over time. We don't want to do we want to do that with the minimum damage we can to the economy, of course. But we have to get inflation down to 2%, and we will. And we just don't see that yet.
Over in China, more signs of an economic slowdown. Beijing's industrial output grew 3.5% in May, slower than the 5.6% expansion in April. Its retail sales, a key indicator of consumer confidence, also slowed to 12.7% from April's 18.4%. As for the Chinese Central Bank, it slashed medium-term lending rates by 10 basis points. That's from 2.75% to now 2.65%. Thursday's move was the bank's first cut since August last year. It came just days after the bank also lowered short-term policy rates in a sign officials are growing more concerned about China's economic picture. Here's a look now at major stock indices in the region. Most Asian markets rise on Thursday thanks to the Fed's pause in rate hikes. We're seeing the Nikkei 225 posting a modest loss, even as Japan exports rose 0.6% to $52 million, beating expectations of a decline. The ASX 200, meanwhile, is up as Australia's unemployment rate fell slightly to 3.6%. adding nearly 76,000 jobs last month. Over in Europe, futures point to a lower open. Traders there are awaiting the next policy decision of the European Central Bank out later today. The ECB is seen to continue hiking its rates, contrasting the Federal Reserve. And in Wall Street, the major indices are down in pre-market open as investors digest the Fed's pause in hikes. Now trading resumes tonight, Manila time. TikTok is committing billions of dollars in Southeast Asia to boost the region's e-commerce market. The short video app's move comes as it continues to face scrutiny in the West over concerns on data security. Southeast Asia is one of TikTok's biggest markets, generating 325 million visitors to the app per month. The investment is expected to focus on training and supporting small vendors to join TikTok's own e-commerce platform. Last year, it facilitated over $4 billion worth of transactions across the region. That is up from the $600 million in 2021, but still lags behind Shopee's $48 billion merchandise sales. The Philippine government sets an ambitious target to grow the country's total exports to $240.5 billion by 2028. That's one of the targets set under the Philippine Export Development Plan 2023 to 2028, launched this morning at the Trade Department's International Trade Forum. The plan sets a total export target of $126.8 billion for this year. In 2022, total export receipts amounting to $78.84 billion was realized. Now the plan is by 2028, electronic and electrical exports will contribute the lion's share to total exports, followed by the IT/BPM sector, as well as minerals. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. assured his administration's support to ensure the development and competitiveness of the export industry.
As envisioned under the PEDP, achieving more than double our current level of exports is, in fact, a realistic target. We can transform the Philippine export industry into a significant economic engine that will generate over 1 million high-quality and sustainable jobs. the Philippines can establish itself as an agile export powerhouse by the year 2028. I once again call on the private sector and the entire export community to continue to invest their faith and energies and resources in the industry. We also send the message of goodwill to our foreign trade partners and the international community. The Philippines will ever be a reliable partner.